face one of the home pairs, Maesari and Sugiyato, or Yila and Sinan. And of course, above them in the bracket, Li Wenmei, Liu Zhuanzhuan still in the mix, Kitty Tarakul and Prajongjai, Zhang Shuxian and Zheng Yu, and a great run so far from Frugard and Toysen from Denmark, all vying for semi-final berths. As you can see, now the two courts in action. China singles affair on court two. That's Heibing Zhao taking on Han Yue. And on court three, it's more mixed doubles action. Zheng Shiwei and Huang Yashong against Tan and Lai from Malaysia. And as you can also see, plenty of fans in attendance already for what was a later start on quarterfinals Friday. And just waiting now for the players to enter the arena on court one. Technical officials and umpires now making their way out. And as always, hats off, a lot of appreciation for all the logistical staff that make these events on the HSBC BWF World Tour so effective. And here come the Malaysians. Against some stiff opposition. Pearly Tan and Tin are now 13th in the world. And in last year's edition, made the semi-finals, but haven't had the best of starts to 2024. First and second round exits in the opening two events. So this is going to be a very significant match for them. And up against Lu Shengshu and Tan Ning. Lu Shengshu, of course, the defending champion herself, but that was with a different partner last year, Zhang Shuxian. So last time they met in the Malaysia Open, and it was Lu and Tan that come through in straight games, and are leading the head-to-head 2-1. Interestingly enough, Liu Shengshu's title-winning partner from last year, Zhang Shuxian, is actually still in the competition with a different partner. So, Shengshu looking for back-to-back titles. Pearly Tan, 23 years old, born up north in Kedah. From a badminton family, her father is a badminton coach. Currently ranked 13, has been as high as 5, and that was January of last year. Last year, a couple of runner-up finishes for them. Pearly, the creative force, Tina, very much the solid structure of their attacking pairing. And they've vowed, literally, to come back strong in 2024. Those were their two results so far. Keng Shu Liang and Zhang Qi in 34 minutes qualifiers there. And then Lombard and Tran, that was last night in 31 minutes. So been flawless so far this week, no games dropped. But this is going to be a tough match for them. Wu Shengshu, 19 years old, born in Liaoning, and is peaking at 5. And what a career so far. Gold at the Sudirman Cup, gold at the Asia Mixed Team Championships, double gold at the World Junior Championships. And with Tan Ning, well, they made 7 finals last year, and they won 4 of them. Of course, had a great run at the Malaysia Open as well. First two results for them. Sung Yu from Chinese Taipei in 37 minutes, Vivian Hu and Lim Chu Sen from Malaysia in 39 minutes. So both pairs have yet to drop a match. Umpire for this one, Herman Armin Mair. Joined by our service judge, Mikhaila Benkova. And another interesting fact, Yu Shengshu and Tan Ning, actually, when they won the Malaysia Open a couple of weeks ago, in straight games, beat Zhang Chuxian and Zheng Yu. So Yu Shengshu beat her old partner to win that first title of the year. But they are in red hot form. So Shengshu and Ning starting in the slightly better side of the court. It's all about adjusting to drift and wind conditions, especially when you're playing the top players. This could be a crunching affair.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Liu Shengshu and Tang Ning, China. And on my left, Pearly Tang and Muralitharan, Tina, Malaysia. Tina Muralitharan to serve to Liu Shengshu. Love all. Play.
So Tina gets us underway. That's not the ideal start.
One, love.
What a wry smile by Tina. She gets hit in the head by her partner. Well, so far, no, it's just two, the opening 2 points, but no structure at all from Pearly and Tina. Can tell you is that Pearly and Tina have been working on their physical conditioning. I think stemming from a belief that they've been outlasted in a few of their matches by their opponents. Best game though. Developed rallies as of yet from both pairs. points falling the way of China. And in terms of unforced error as well, that's definitely a lot more on the Malaysian side. Response as soon as they get on the attack, Liu and Tan. It's danger.
Six,
steep and fast. And quite relentless. Well, what a career Liu Shengshu especially has ahead of her at 19 years old, ranked 5. Picking up titles early on. Forcing the errors here.
7-2.
Would do the Malaysian ladies a great deal of good if they could make the semi-finals, based of course on ranking points. It always helps to have that equal or higher finish. Especially with such a tight qualifying race. Very late take by Tina. Oh, just can't help faulting at the moment. Nothing going right for them so far. Quality winners left, right and center. 11-3 at the break after just 5 minutes on court. So back on court, Hun Tien Hao, one of the Malaysian coaches, with the advice, and really at this point, based on the opening phase of play,
11,
it's just about settling down and getting into some kind of rhythm. That's going to be rewarding for them. And that's far more emphatic from Pearly Tan.
Bye.
Big power from Tan Ning at the back. That's a much better rally for the Malaysians. Pearly Tan there, ready to clear up at the net. Did some solid work from her partner. That's good pressure. Well, whatever it was that Hun Tien Hao and the Malaysian coaching staff said to them at the break, seems to have worked a treat. And Tina being a lot more patient in the rallies, waiting for their opportunity. So all Tan Ning.
12-6.
Well, 6 points back, this first game might just be beyond them. But certainly encouraging signs as they have now started building up the rallies. 31 shots, longest rally we've seen so far. Certainly moving forward. Serve from Tin Up. And that's well left by Tan Ning. So 13-7. Oh, tried to vary it up. Clips the net. Intentional or not, it works for Liu and Tan. I think they may have just done enough in this first game. Back defense, that's called in. No challenge coming. Five. wonderfully opportunistic at the net. My Tan Ning covered the space so quickly. Dropped in right side front court. Well, the home fans here at the Historis and Ion just love, of course, their home players to make it through. And in the women's doubles division, there's only one pair left from Indonesia, and that's Maesari and Sugiyarto. And they, of course, might just be the opponents for whoever wins this match in the semis. Saying that, though, of course, there's four Indonesian pairs left in the men's doubles draw. And we'll be watching the final Indonesian entrant in the women's singles up after this match. Right now, though, 16-11, Nguyen Tan on serve. Well, they were 11-2 down. And they're back up to 12-16. So it has been a lively comeback from Malaysian ladies. But a service error there, costly. Late take. And well placed reply from Pearly Tan just on the outside. Very difficult with that grip to return for Tan Ning. 13-17, they're closing it up. Serve. It's given them the advantage. Solid enough defense. Forces the mistake. Well, these are much better rallies and much better points now being produced. Well, these roars that you're hearing from around the arena, it's because there is, in fact, another Indonesian doubles pair currently up. That's Kusujanto and Kusumawati taking on Toft and Gravison. Of course, the winner of that will play Midorikawa and Saito in the semi-finals after their fantastic performance to kick off action here on court one on day four. And don't forget, they were down 11-2. Might maybe a case of too little too late in this first game. Body shot there from Tan Ning is going to do well enough. But it does, for the Malaysians at least, bode well for the second game. Just maybe a bit slow to get into their rhythm. And I think that's probably what their coach, Tian Hao, reminded them of. Play. That's wonderful from Muralitharan, gives him the advantage. And again, a little stop drop into front court. And they're right back in it. A trademark in many ways. Muralitharan. Bit rushed by Nguyen-Tan. That's going to go wide. 16-19. Big power coming in from the back and the front. And Sheng Shu with the killing blow in the end. And that's given them 4 game points.
20 game point 16.
Oh, great defense by him. Yu Shengshu, that wins the point and the game. 21-16 in 19 minutes. So back on court for game two. And that looked like Li Mengyan with Hun Tianhao. And the Malaysian coaching staff used to play, of course, with Chao Mei Kwan. So important match, important game, I should say, for Pearlie and Tina onto the slightly better side of the court, though that hasn't really played out in terms of results for the pairs and players that have been on that side. Certainly didn't work out for Zhang Zhenbang and Wei Yazin earlier. But after reviving their fortunes from being 11-2 down, to finish 21-16 is admirable for Tan and Tina, but they have to capitalize on that, make it work for them here. That's a good drop in by Liu Shengshu into front court. And of course the Chinese pair can now play with a little bit more freedom that they've taken that first game. Oh, that's a late take by Muralitharan. And that's in. Have to get their reads at backcourt. A little bit more sharper. another fault.
Three,
right now, they just seem to be powering that shuttle through the Malaysian rackets. Happened two or three times already. Well, read by Yu Shengshu.
4-1.
So not critical yet, but a 4-1 lead. Certainly something to keep an eye on for the Malaysians. They don't want that getting any bigger. That's great from Tina. Pearly comes through to finish off. Trying to shift the angle left and right. That's great from Tinar as well, but oh, that's into the corner and it's in. First challenge of the match. I think it's good. Great vision to find that corner. I think Talan Tinar will be lucky here. Absolutely on the line.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Service over. 5-2.
So 5-2. One challenge remaining for them. And with that kind of accuracy coming from Liu and Tan, let's hope they don't need that extra challenge. That last remaining challenge, I should say, another fault off Pearly Tan's racket. Trying to lift it to the back. And that certainly looked like it caught a little bit of that left-right drift. And that's what I mean. It's not just in one isolated area of the court. It's more of a general breeze from left to right. So you really have to keep an eye on those shots played from the Malaysians into their left side, because they will get carried away.
8-2,
and things again looking a bit tight here. Good idea. Doesn't work out for them. That signature move from Pearly Tan. Well, that's more like the Valentina that we have seen before. Good combination, probably does the setup. Valentina comes in with a big steep angle. And they do, when they get their rhythm in, make a very good combination in terms of their skill sets. That's wide, no challenge coming. Defense by Malaysian ladies. Tan and Ning looking for a way through. Now moving forward. And that's the relentless pressure from Tan Ning. That was a tricky serve. 11-5 at the break, and still trying to find a way through this solid China attack. Well, it's a crucial passage of play for Pearlie Tan and Tina. Second phase, game two. 6 points back. That's a very smart shot by Liu Shengshu. Just below the hip on the left side. Good start to that. What could be a winning run here. Very calmly now. Shen Xu and Tan. They won in Malaysia. It was a first round exit in India last week. That was to Miyara and Sakuramoto in straight games. But they look like they have bounced back in style here at the Indonesia Masters. defense has been solid. They've been patient, and the attack has been effective. 15-5. Well, what can the Malaysians do here? They're now trying to go for power. But again, shuttle keeps coming back. Oh, it's a wonderful pattern of play, and again they've come through.
16-5.
Well, credit to Pearlie and Tina for trying absolutely everything, but there is a sense of inevitability now. Liu Shengshu's face. One, two. Just couldn't get the third. Oh, what a time for a service error. Sorry, I was just giving so much credit to that previous scoreline. It's nowhere near that close. Pearlie again trying and trying. And here they come. It's last ditch, and that's out. Well, lucky, because they were literally at their last ditch chance. That's the longest rally that we've seen so far, and it might just be one of the last rallies that we see. Because things very tight now for Talentina. 10 points back. No mistakes allowed past the 15th point, you'd feel. Nice touch by Tan Ning, who's now playing up front. How did Pearlie Tan miss that? Absolutely glorious attempt. Liu Shengshu on the floor. You couldn't ask for a better opportunity than that. Once again, they fought valiantly, but it just hasn't been enough. Oh, good tempo to this game, good pace. has been going one way. That's a good rotation by Liu and Tan. And that's a nice little touch in by Tina. Say no mistakes allowed, that one's gone very wide. So there's a good chance they might be able to close it out on this service. 2 points needed. And they are through to their second semi-final from three events. And what could lead, of course, to a second title in three events in 2024. Relentless pressure from Tan Ning at the net. Well, that's this ability to take shots from whatever body position she happens to be in. So 12 match points. Picking their spot, almost. Bit too delicate that time. So they've done it in 39 minutes. ...21-16, 21-9, it is a second semi-final in three events for Liu Shengshu and Tan Ning, and of course Liu Shengshu looking for back-to-back titles here in Indonesia
Liu Shengshu and Tan Ning
with a brand new partner this year.
16, 21-9.
That's the final point. And it was again well placed. It was a difficult return for Pearly Tan. Such an effective pair when they get going. And there's confirmation of it. 21-16, 21-9, 39 minutes. And Liu Shengshu and Tan Ning progress. We'll be right back. So progressing on here on court one, and it was a 40-minute victory for Liu Shengshu and Tan Ning. And up next, well, it's going to be a huge cheer in this arena when Gregoria Mariska Tunjung steps into the court to take on former world number one, Nozomi Okuhara.